Welcome back. In the previous video, we talked about data types in Python, and we said the numeric data types consist of integers, floating point numbers, and then complex numbers. Now, the integers are just positive and negative whole numbers. So 1, 2, minus 5, 0 are all integers. And then the floating point numbers consist of numbers that has what? Decimal part. So let's say 2.0 6.7 and many more are all floating point numbers, not forgetting the negative part too. So negative 5.6 or let's say 8 are all floating point numbers. And then complex numbers, well, if you haven't done higher mathematics, you wouldn't know of complex numbers. So many programming instructors don't talk about complex numbers. But if you want to use Python to perform some complex mathematical operations, then you should know of these. Since this is not a mathematical course, we won't spend much time on these numeric data types, but we are going to use them a lot in our programming journey. So we will just brush through and see how they can help us on the way. Now, what you should know is that we can perform the basic mathematical arithmetic or mathematical operations on the numeric data types. That is, we can add two integers, as we know already, and we can also subtract two integers. We can also multiply two integers, let's say 3 times 5, and we can also divide 2 integers, let's say 4 divided by 2. So if I print this, we have 1 plus 1, 2, and then 2 minus 5, minus 3, 3 times 5, we have 15, and then 4 divided by 2, we have 2.0. What you should know is that whenever that you divide 2 integers, you get a floating point number. That is why we have 2.0. So if you want the integer part, if you want to perform a division and you want only the integer part, we have something called floor division or integer division. And this is how we do it. You use, let's say, you want to perform 5 on 2. So you want the integer part. You use another forward slash. And then if you run this, we get 2. All right. Although 5 on 2. Let's see what 5 on 2 will give us. 5 on 2 is what? 2.5. But the integer division only gives us the integer part. It takes off the floating point part. It runs on to infinity, negative infinity. So that is how it works. We can also do exponentiation. That is 2 raised to the power, let's say, 3, and this is how we write to raise the power. See how we write the multiplication, a star, and then if you want to perform exponentiation, use double star. So 2 raised to the power 3 is what? 8. And then we have it here. So that is how we perform exponentiation. And if you want to find modulo, let's say 5 modulo 2, we expect what? 1. That is 5 divided by 2. The remainder will be what? 1. So that is the basic arithmetic that we can use Python to perform. Now let's look at the complex parts. So we can define complex numbers in this way: whether you are attached a number to j, so 2 plus, let's say 3j, and then we run this, we get a complex number. Or you can say complex, then you put the numbers. The first one represents the real part, and then the second one represents the imaginary part. So if you run this, you'll get the same thing. So that is how we define complex numbers. You can add complex numbers as we did for integers. You can also add, divide, and multiply floating point numbers, as we know already. And then the complex numbers, if I define two complex numbers, I can add them. Let's say A, then I assign, let's say 1 plus 2j, right? And I say B, then I assign only the complex part to this. So Python sees this as imaginary number. The real part is zero. So if I add a plus b, see what we have, 1 plus the real part of b is what, 0, and then the imaginary part of this one is 2. When you add it to this one, you get 3. So you have 1 plus 3j. You can perform division, multiplication. So let's see how division will work. A on b, we have 2 minus 1j, a times b minus 2 plus 1j. So this is how we perform operations on complex numbers. We can also find the conjugate of a complex number. All right, so let's say a is what, 1 plus 2j, and then the conjugate of a complex number, we say this is how we find the conjugate. And then if I run this, I'm expecting what, 1 minus 2j, as we have here, just negation of the imaginary part. It's as simple as that. Now we also have something called PEMDAS. You might have heard of it as board mass, or better still, PEMDAS. All right, so we have something also called order of operations or order of precedence. That is when you are performing mathematical operations on, let's say, a sequence of numbers. So if you have this, then minus 2 times 3, what do you think this is going to give us? What Python sees, or what any calculator sees, is it takes parentheses first. Now everything here is in parentheses, so obviously it's going to do what is in the parentheses first. Then the next thing it takes is exponentiation. Where can we find our exponentiation? Here. Then multiplication next, division, addition and subtraction. But what you should know is that multiplication and division have the same order of precedence. So when they meet, Python does the calculation from the left. So that the one that is at the left, Python does it. And then addition and subtraction also have the same order of precedence. One is not superior to the other. So if you run this, we are getting minus 152. Probably this is not what you were expecting. You were expecting 10 minus 2 to be done first. So computers are not clever. It only does what you tell it to do. So make sure you are explicit enough in your commands. That is, if you wanted to perform 10 minus 2 first, you should have indicated with enough bracket. So we can say, still put one bracket here, and then we put another one here before we say times 2, all right, times 3 rather, and then raise the power 4, and this will give us a different answer, 648. So make sure you add bracket to make your computer do what you expect it to do. Otherwise, it will do it the way it understands it. So let's end here and talk a little more about numeric data types in the next video. Bye-bye.